So Emily, one thing before we get started on talking about Flutter, I noticed when I looked at our internal site and I was like doing a little bit of research about you, like your job title was Chief Meme Officer.
Yes.
What's with that?
So internally, Google has a culture of creating, we call them memes, technically image macros, to joke about and comment about things that are going on internally in the company. Yep. And amongst our team, I have done more than my fair share. So my manager started calling me the Chief Meme Officer, and I'm now tasked with keeping the team up to date on trends in the company about memes.
Nice, yes. Nice. I mean, I love memes both inside and outside of Google. Of course, we have them outside too, so it's like I have to watch out for some of your memes. So when you're not memeing, you're also a software engineer, right? And you're working on Flutter?
Dart, actually.
Dart. Oh, so Flutter, Dart. How do they all work together?
Yeah, Dart is the programming language that Flutter is then built on top of.
Okay.
And so I've been on the Dart team for quite a while. Dart is about 6 years old.
Okay.
And when it was originally created, it was intended to be a web programming language.
Okay.
I personally work on the Dart to JavaScript compiler.
Okay.
So if you want to deploy a Dart application on the web, we will be assisting you with that.
Nice.
But as Dart has evolved, and there's many more use cases aside from just web, I mean, internally in the team,
right.
We use it to as just a general sort of scripting language. And then Dart has also been applied to mobile.
Okay.
And I'm super excited about how Flutter is using it.
Right.
To basically deploy on iOS and Android as mobile applications.
So tell me a little bit about Dart as a language. Like, what's exciting and what's interesting about it?
It's a very approachable scripting style language.
Okay.
It is syntactically pretty similar to things like Java, JavaScript, and that sort of thing. When I first came to the Dart team, because Dart hadn't been created yet, I obviously didn't know Dart, but I found it very easy to pick up.
Okay.
It's designed to be very familiar, and I just programmed kind of like generic C-ish language,
right.
And it worked. And then once you got familiar with that, you can move on. There's lots of nice idioms, and
nice.
Makes it very concise. It has some functional components as well that are
cool.
Awesome.
So now I can use all of that, and with Dart to JS, I can spit out JS code and
yes.
like run it in a browser.
Yes. Wow. Yeah. So you can deploy, so it can run on, you know, Firefox anywhere on the web.
Okay.
And what's cool about how Dart was designed is it is well suited for being both JITted and ahead of time compiled.
Okay.
And so a little compiler lesson, if I don't know how up on compilers. So basically, you have interpreters on your extreme end of the spectrum of
right.
like literally going token by token and executing as you go.
Yep.
You have ahead of time compilation for C++ and those sorts of things. Run GCC, get yep. x86.
Yep.
And then JITting is kind of in between. You're like, oh, I'm running this particular function a whole lot. I need to optimize it. I'll compile that little chunk into machine code.
Right.
And the cool thing with JITting is it gives a really nice developer experience. So it's kind of webby and like you save your file and it goes and updates.
Right.
Flutter takes that webby style of development where you're just like, I'm gonna build a button, save,
yeah.
and then it it's appears.
Yeah.
And then because Dart also can be ahead of time compiled, we compile it down to native like ARM code. And it will be super smooth and super performant.
Nice.
So it's pretty much like have your cake, eat it too.
So yeah, like I can see you're clearly excited about Flutter and how Dart fits in with it. And you know, one of the things I did an interview with Eric, and like he was like telling me about how like Flutter has been designed to run on the metal. And something that came to mind with that to me was that it might make it a lot easier for learning.
Mm-hmm. That is an area that I think has not yet been explored enough,
okay.
But I think it has a lot of potential. When you are learning any just computer science in general, or if you're doing mobile app development, you're obviously gonna be making mistakes.
Right.
And with hot reloading, you can, particularly with mobile, like you can see the part that's working and not.
Right.
And so you're like, okay, well, I need to add this button, and I messed up a semicolon. this little chunk is broken, but like, oh, I'll just hot reload rather than having to like wait, build,
right.
And then like, oh, this is a couple screens in, I have to find it. It's all just there.
I've run code labs, and a lot of times, particularly for people who are learning something for the first time, and it's hard enough to get them to understand, okay, this is code, but you got to get them to, okay, this is code, and now I'm compiling it, and now I'm deploying it, and now the emulator's booting up, and now the application's loading in the emulator, and now the debugger's booting up, and there's all those concepts that they have to learn before they can see their button.
Yeah, and that aren't even related to the idea of algorithms.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Just eliminate that stuff. Yeah.
It was great stuff to learn, but you probably don't want it on day one.
Yeah, you don't need it on day one.
So the whole idea of being able to, like you say, just I want a button and the button is just there without going through all that compile loop is pretty cool. But
it's instant gratification for programmers, basically.
Yeah, exactly. So that to me would be the hook. Right, that hooks me into Flutter and think, I gotta check this out. I gotta kick the tires on this to see if it suits me as a developer. Are there any other cool things about it, you know, that would hook you as a developer?
So if you are if you're a web developer, like Dart is a great segue, or Flutter is a great segue because you can take what you know if you know Dart,
right.
And then develop in mobile, and it's a very familiar development experience, then the cross-platform thing is amazing too. So Flutter takes care of compiling your code to iOS and Android, so you don't have to learn two different languages.
Right.
You don't have to worry about spinning up two different teams with two different code bases that do the same thing.
Nice.
And then Dart itself, So there's Dart 2 that has just come out, has been announced relatively recently. As we were saying, like, Dart has been evolving over time, and so we were seeing how it's being used, and Dart 2 has a lot of changes that modernize the language.
Right.
Things like optional new and const, and then we also are adding a lot more, have a more robust type system.
Cool.
Because turns out people want to be not we surprised.
Like, yeah, we like types.
Yes. So yeah, it's a lot of things to help make developers' lives nicer.
Now, one of the things that whenever we hear across platform and it works on iOS and it works on Android that gets the spidey senses tingling is that, you know, often we see these kind of things, but it's just web with a thin veneer over it and then it's lowest common denominator. But Flutter is very different from that, right?
Right. No, Flutter is literally native code, so compiling to ARM, what have you.
Right.
And this is the magic of the Dart VM. basically is doing all of this compilation, so there's no weird interaction between native code and Flutter code because it is native code, and Flutter is drawing all of those pixels.
Yep, so it is an app, or it is, you know, that kind of thing actually running. It's not a bundle of web stuff.
Right, right.
Okay, cool. So I'm a developer and I want to get started. What do I do?
Well, you can go to flutter.io,
okay.
And download things. There's also a bunch of YouTube talks, some of them featuring someone looks kind of like this.
Yeah, I heard you did a talk at I.O. and the memeing came back, right?
Yes. So yeah.
We've come full circle.
Yes, yes. We gave a talk last year at I.O. and we'll actually be at I.O. this year as well. But we're doing a live coding an app in Flutter, 30 minutes, both iOS and Android, and we were doing a basically live or an insta meme, so meme chat is what we called it, but
nice.
Chatting via image macros, basically.
Okay. Now here you had to put some very custom memes in that, is that
yes.
Right?
Well, because of we didn't want to have to worry about copyright infringement of very famous memes.
Yep.
We, at the last minute, ran around and recreated a lot of famous memes. So we got ones of, like, you know, the Bart Simpson where he's like slowly going into the bush.
Yep. That's Homer, right?
Oh yes,
Homer
sorry,
vanishing
Homer.
Into the
my
bush. I love that meme. So yes.
So you have I'm like slowly sinking into the bushes.
Oh, I gotta see that one. I really want to do a facepalm one.
Oh, we did that. We had like a triple facepalm. We had a couple of people on the Flutter team all be like.
Nice. So that's your I.O. talk and that's online?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Well, we'll put a link to it in the comments below so people can see it. So again, if I want to get started and I want to build this kind of stuff myself, so your talk is going to show me how to do it. But then download the bits from just Flutter.io. Okay.
And yeah, Flutter is now beta, which is super exciting. It's a level of stability that some people were unsure about in the early days, but yeah, it's great components, lots of awesome support with Firebase.
Right. I've heard of Firebase.
Yeah. And and something that is near and dear to my heart, but Flutter supports animated GIFs.
Okay.
For added memeing opportunities.
Added memeing opportunities. And you call them GIFs, not GIFs, but hopefully our viewers.
Yeah, hopefully no one hates me. Depending on what team I'm on, it's GIFs or GIFs.
So one thing though is that really stunned me when I've been like kind of learning a little bit about Flutter was that it was alpha for a long time, and you just mentioned it's only just gotten into beta. But despite it being alpha, lots of people were building great apps on it. And that to me is very rare. You know, usually when something is in alpha, developers will play with it and think about planning for the future, but you've had lots of great apps built on it. Do you have any favorites?
Favorite of mine. I love the Hamilton app. It's based on the Hamilton musical.
Yep, absolutely.
It is the official app. You can get, there's like ticket lotteries and all sorts of things. There's fun like native overlays. You can like take a picture of yourself with a King George crown.
What comes next?
Yeah.
I have the app myself and I enter the lottery every day, but I haven't won yet. Because it's running in Seattle. I'm from Seattle and you're based in Seattle too. And it's almost done in Seattle, but I haven't won a ticket yet. So.
I haven't seen it yet though.
Cut. Okay, so again, flutter.io if somebody wants to get started. So thank you so much, Emily. This has been so much fun. Thanks, everybody, for watching this episode of Coffee with a Googler. Again, if you have any questions for me or if you have any questions for Emily, please leave them in the comments below, and we'd love to see what you build on Flutter. Thank you.